Pain in children. As the last descendants of Hortense, who descended through crabs, fish, swallows, and trickier forms, we higher mammals have an innate nociceptive system at birth and even before. A system sensitive to attack that signals us in the form of pain. Without this system, a person feels nothing and can let himself die without uttering a word. When we hurt, we cry, groan, and complain. That seems obvious. However, there are mute pains, and mimicking, posture, and gesticulation express this pain through a system of codes, through a nonverbal language. As strange as it may seem, we learn the language of pain just as we later learn our mother tongue. The language of pain is used to express our suffering, to protest, warn, call for help, or beckon to someone. Like any language, it enables us to communicate with others. The first of our species that we encounter in life is our mother, or a mother substitute. Between these two closely linked beings, a process takes place. Beyond words, each tries to understand what the other is feeling, to put himself or herself in the other's place. In this way, the mother can associate certain of her baby's expressions, even his silences, with pain, and come to his aid. The baby understands that a certain signal brings consolation and will repeat it. A system of codes and signs develops between mother and child, a language, but it's a very rudimentary language, and it's not easy to understand a child's expression of pain even for its mother, not to mention strangers. Sometimes, doctors and healthcare personnel don't realize that a baby's in pain and neglect the pain relievers and anesthetics that are regularly given to adults. Never believe that a child who doesn't cry isn't hurting. He eventually learns to express his pain in our language. Meanwhile, the child has to learn how to evaluate his pain and express it. And we adults should never neglect any aspect of a child's behavior that may express pain.